So you're saying I have to take the vaccine whenever it finally arrives?
I mean, the way I look at the vaccine is this. We're not going to get to take it for a while anyways. So, like, let everyone...
You're not. Canada's got locked and loaded, man. We're going to get pumped up full of vaccine. I might even be able to get two before you get one.
Oh, a double dose.
Eileen and I are coming back for that. We're coming back for that. Direct flight to Toronto. We're there.
You get two vaccines, you never get sick again.
Period.
You,
sick again.
You never cough.
Or you get the sickest. Yeah. Or you get the sickest forever. You're just always sick.
Yeah, you just turn inside out.
You never die from coronavirus. You just always have a little bit of coronavirus.
You're always just horking out some shit.
Sponsored by Big Rona.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to High with Ty. I'm your host, Dr. Tyler Lemco. And what a panel today. What wonderful guests do I have? Holy shit. Up first, we have the world-renowned chef, food artist, Mr. Josh Elkin. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. What up, Ty? What up, Lemme Kno? What up, Dave?
Josh.
Tyler.
What's the oldest person thing about you?
Wow. Drinking a copious amount of coffee in the morning and not brushing my teeth.
Ooh, ever.
Ever.
Good old man move.
That's an old man move. Hot coffee breath.
You just always smell like teacher.
Just so much hot coffee.
What's your thoughts on a Werther's original?
Love sucking on him.
Yeah.
Also, the sleeper Werther's original is the chocolate filled ones.
Ooh. Werther's original, my favorite dessert.
Knife and fork it.
We've also got the incredibly talented, wonderful Mr. Dave Heuff. How are you?
I am well, thank you. Those lies that you let me in with are very, very kind.
No, Dave.
Shut up. Shut up.
What's the most expensive thing you've broken?
Ooh.
Friendships.
My ego?
Ooh, let's get into it.
Nice. Go on.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes you just you gotta knock yourself down a peg or two, and those humbling moments are the ones that keep the old ticker going at a pace that makes life worth living.
Yeah, sage advice from Dave Huff. Yeah. Finally, we have the incomparable, my literal brother from my literal mother, Mr. Lemme Kno. How are you?
Greetings.
Lemme Kno. What would a world populated by clones of you be like?
Is it just him and just the clones? Or are there other people too?
Let's say there's everyone.
50-50?
Yeah, let's say it's 50% of the world and the other 50% is Adam.
That's a whole different one. I was thinking all me. Okay. I don't want to say there'd be like a takeover or anything, right? Like...
Who's going to take over?
But there
who's taking over? You're all you.
It's 50% of the population now.
Yeah, but do you work well with yourself?
I think if it was all me, we'd get along fine. You threw 50% other people. That's hard.
I think there would be a lot of in-arguing. You guys know the song Magic Stick?
Yes, of course. By 50 Cent.
Classic.
No, not 50 Cent, but you know it. That they kept the green screen shot of the guy who just kneeled down.
Right.
I'll show you magic. The game is whack. Yes, it's whack. Stand like you want it. Can every.
Where's he from?
I want to say like the bottom of the ocean. I don't know.
All I do is mag. After early in the morning, back shot. I smoke.
Stop in there.
They forgot about the green screen.
Yeah, no, they only had a little bit of footage to work with.
That's right.
Take in those like Stitches exhaust jeans, though.
Yeah, that could be your like this video could be dated, right?
Yeah.
The cars all look like they are like early 2000s models.
Yeah.
So there we go. He's in the club.
I love the shots where he just leaves for like seconds on end.
He's just walking away. He's just like, nah, I'm done with my own shoes.
He looks like a SpongeBob cat. Whoa, what was that?
No, I need more of that
what
shot.
What was that?
I need more of that shot. Go back. I mean, overall, he is pretty low energy. He's just casually right. strolling.
This I would say he's not ready he's yet. All right.
Okay.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Why did you preface the video with the magic stick?
Well, the song is the magic stick.
Magic.
I got magic.
He chanted magic, magic for 4 minutes
stick.
Just now.
Magic. I didn't hear one other lyric.
He literally was holding a stick, which he picked up and put down 6 times throughout the video.
I missed that part. Just totally missed it.
I love that this isn't a YouTube video. This is like you downloaded this from LimeWire.
Yeah, I got it off Kaza in 99, and I've been saving it for this very moment.
Incredible foresight.
Yeah. I was thinking back the other day about that like big orange brick computer that I used to have in my bedroom upstairs, and on it there was editing software. And I was like, cool, I'm going to start editing songs together. And I remember downloading like hundreds of songs, and I downloaded transitions with like static and channel changing noise. And I spent a solid 6 months every day after school editing this like 3 hour long track of like my favorite verses, and then a transition to another song and another verse and then a transition. And I would pick out my favorite verses, and I made this monster track of my favorite verses. And then I remember being like 13 one day and finishing this project and then being like, why?
Like, how am I supposed to get to the middle of the song?
I finished it and then I had it and I was like, this sucks.
That was around the time where like you dropped wrestling and beating yourself up and yeah. just the transition between before you realized you want to play basketball.
Yeah, I was directionless, so I was diving into like, the music. All right, guys, video number 2. This is just a cool-ass guy making a rap song about courting women, and it's not creepy at all.
Oh, boy.
I got your girlfriend drunk.
Nope.
That's not drunk.
You know my name is the one. Young said to the head, and I'm a real true drunk. He's off that feel-good funk, so you know he ain't right. Up in the club, boy, I'm looking for some love tonight.
Tyler shared the stage with this guy in 2009.
This place, the place that he's at right now.
Yeah. I got your girlfriend.
Got a Letterkenny vibe.
Now it sounds to me, I know he's bragging about like, I got your girlfriend drunk. Seems to me like he spent a lot of money on someone else's
on other people's girls.
Want you love, baby, but that don't mean you gon' break me. I'll let you know now for sure. I ain't no Johnny come late, and you can love me or hate me. That's what you get, your boy a rug. Tipping on the sub, got your girl getting fucked up.
He's saying it like he's proud, right?
Either that, or he spent like $80 from his telemarketing job on someone's girlfriend that night who went home and had sex with her boyfriend.
Got your girlfriend now she acting kind of gypsy. I said I gotta go for the liquor store clothes. Wanna roll with me?
It serves the song well. It goes with what he's saying. It's just the girlfriend drunk. Gotta go, buddy. And maybe him. He's gotta go.
I got your girlfriend.
He was like, oh, I have the perfect shirt for this song.
I got your girlfriend drunk.
It's got a bad vibe.
It's got a very bad vibe. It's eye-opening how awful we used to allow people to be.
Well, that's it. Yeah. I mean, people weren't conscious back then about what kind of message they were portraying, I guess, because
real assaulty vibes in that way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a lot of things wrong with that.
Thanks for reminding us, Ty, of this era we've worked so hard to get past. Way to drag us right back into it.
Dude's name is Young Said, aka Young Said TV.
Okay.
Okay.
Shout out.
Shout out to Young Said.
Here's his Instagram. Right.
His website is no longer valid. Young Said, no longer.
Oh, he's definitely not rapping.
All right, let's get it.
Whoa, he's a wrestler now?
Any wrestling footage?
No, but he does have fangs now.
Oh,
he has fangs now. He's definitely changed.
Yeah. I think after this video, he kind of realized he has to shift. You know, yeah, he's got to shift a little bit.
He pivoted, I guess.
Yeah, he's picture that.
That's not him. Cool. That's Gangrel.
That's yeah, that's him. Gangrel.
Maybe he is Gangrel.
Did we just watch a whole video of Gangrel?
That was not Gangrel. I know Gangrel when I see him.
Maybe it is Gangrel.
If there's anything I know, it's Gangrel.
It's true.
I will be the one to love and cover you from now until the day I die. I will take you places that you only can.
Before four.
Yeah.
Because they used to be four, now they're three.
Well, no, it's the three of them in this little black kid.
So, I like that it's a kid's perspective, so they go like with a cross shot to start. So it's like twice. Like...
Yeah, right? And the song's about going down on someone.
Yeah, and the video...
These guys look like Saturday Night Live characters.
they definitely do.
They're strong guys, and for some reason...
tank tops.
It's a song about going down and doing oral sex, and yet the star of the video is like a little kid who's stealing their girls.
Yeah, it's really weird. Yeah, really weird. And there's too many tank tops. There's too many necklaces.
They look like they're all wearing the same mask.
Oh, basketball. Nice.
So this raining. the whole video is about them getting cucked by this little kid. If you wanna take it slow. No pressure to go all the way. They actually look dope.
All this is in style right now, by the way, guys.
Yeah.
Like, a little you don't bit wear tighter. Pads when you play basketball, do you?
No, but when you rap, you do. Drake told us that.
Oh, right.
It's a life jacket.
It's raining. Playing a baggy sweater, by the way, just so you know.
Are they brothers?
Yeah, right? Are they brothers?
They have to be.
Are they? Well, they're clones.
They were all made in the same lab together.
This kid is no more than 12 years old. He's like picking up grown women and driving a Ferrari. What?
And like on their behalf? I don't get it.
On their before.
Tyler,
wow,
you need so
that old dude gets to do all that.
Yeah. Tyler, you need to make a continuation of that video.
I'm the homeless guy. I'm part two. And I put it on, I'm like, what the fuck? And all of that for a song about sucking and fucking.
Right?
You know?
How'd they slip those on the airwaves?
No, in fact, the final chorus, their high-pitched squealing in the background, let me give it to you, baby.
Yeah. And then I don't know if you heard it, but in the background, there's a low voice that just goes, come for me. Come for me.
Shut up and come.
Let me know. What was the best thing about the year 2000? Other than B44.
It was the last year I was forced to go to school. Everything else was by choice.
Nice.
Yeah.
So the year 2000 is when you took life in your own hands, I guess. Exactly. Nice, good answer.
You became the keeper of your own destiny. Yeah.
Up next is hands down my new favorite song.
Oh boy.
talking all this shit. No, we know we go in the killer, go in the kitchen, nigga. No, we go in the killer, shooting extension, nigga. No, get it. Nigga, you talking that shit, you know we go in and killin' that shit. Nigga, they talking that shit, you know we and you're not doing that shit, standing that shit. No way I get in the place. Nigga, not own that shit. Nigga, I get that shit.
I don't trust these guys.
Why? What makes you say that?
He looks like he's on something big time.
Imagine being the cameraman. Not enough blinking.
Yeah, he definitely looks like he needs a glass of water.
This guy hasn't blinked since the 90s.
How about the smoke machine in the background?
No, that's a real fire, they say. I mean, there's not a lot of diversity in his lyrics.
I'm gonna need that link.
Yeah. Yeah, you will.
Dave's gonna show that to his kids when they're being bad.
Oh my god, they're gonna be terrified.
No, he's gonna put it on for them to go to sleep.
Boys.
Josh.
Yeah.
What's the coolest thing you own?
The coolest? Wow, that's a great question. The coolest thing I own probably has to be my electric bicycle.
That's very Los Angeles of you, Josh.
It is. It's electric. It goes 30 miles an hour. It.
All right, we don't have to plug them.
What? Yeah, Super 73 lithium cycle.
Thicktireelectricbikes.com.
Yeah,
I'd say that's the coolest thing I own.
Use code Josh Elkin for 10% off your electric bikes.
No.
Don't forget to install the Honey browser to get an extra discount.
I figured I'd slow it down a little bit for you guys. Let's change up the pace.
Oh, he's singing.
I want a girlfriend.
You gotta give this guy credit for the soul patch sideburns.
Yeah, they are crazy. I've done that.
I don't care if he's black or white or green. Or maybe hello. I want a girlfriend.
He wants a girlfriend.
He's diverse, is what he's saying.
Yeah.
He's a diverse individual.
Girlfriend. So where are you? I don't care if you are Chinese.
English isn't his first language, right?
He doesn't have a first language.
I was going to say language isn't his first language.
Love is his first language.
Exactly.
I want a girlfriend. I want a girlfriend.
You speak it into existence, you know?
Say it enough times.
There's a lot of intent in this video and song. And for that, this guy gets my vote.
I want a girlfriend.
Right, now he's just complaining.
I know this music sucks. But if you are there, I am waiting for you.
I need to know, did that get him a girlfriend?
You know, I kind of respect it because 99.9% of stuff you see, people just put out to get views or to get seen.
Guys,
he didn't
guys.
Care about the views.
No, he cared about love.
He wasn't in it for the notoriety.
All he wants is a girlfriend.
Wait, Josh has news.
He's famous on TikTok, this guy.
Ooh.
Really?
That'll get him.
He's got just about 10,000 followers on TikTok.
Is it just Gangrel?
I have updates on I have updates on Gangrel too. Hold on.
You'll never guess. He was in this thing called The Brood in 98 with Edge and Christian. The real girlfriend is the views you get along the way. I don't know. Dave.
Yeah.
What's the worst bar you've ever been to?
The worst bar? Yeah, definitely been there.
How about the one where the guy got stabbed and we all had to leave?
Yeah, I was peeing next to him.
That's the one. Shea Paul, worst bar I've ever been to.
Yeah, we didn't say the name.
We were there. We saw things starting to happen that we didn't like. So we went home, and the next day in the news,
a
man was stabbed right there.
I remember that on Gwen.
You guys were outside. I was in the urinal when they rushed in and started stabbing him, and I was mid-pee, and I had to decide, do I finish this pee or not? All right, guys. Your final video of the show is about two lovely ladies just making a song about some of their favorite things. So,
whoa.
It's these two girls. I think they're dating, and they love weed, poop, and farts.
You think they told all these other people what the song's about?
I think this is a very close-knit community of like-minded people.
Is that a cross?
Yeah, they brought Jesus into it.
Hey, Zeus is in here too.
If they're having fun, I'm not hating. I'm just saying if they're doing this for the reasons I think they are, which is like viral capability.
Oh, no, this video had 1,000 views.
Okay, good. I'm happy about this video. I like this video more.
They just love pooping farts.
Guys, it's not real poop, right?
I hope not. Maybe they're method.
I'm telling myself it's not poop. I don't care if it is.
I really don't want it to be.
If it is, it's a bad one.
So, I'm going to need the link for that one, too.
Yeah, I got you.
That video was the opposite of the coronavirus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, both are kind of shitty.
Yeah, yes. That was the exact opposite of the coronavirus.
It's like,
they were not social distancing.
No.
I have yet to read anything anywhere that you could through smearing someone's shit all over yourself. Let's talk about wiping, though. There's a lot of different techniques. But what's your wipe?
You're setting me up, eh?
I'm setting you up because I know I hate your wife.
I hate your wife. I just want to say before you get into this, I have two brothers and I don't know if I know a single one of their wipe techniques.
If one of your brothers reached his arm into the hole in the middle and wiped forward, would know.
I mean,
yeah, of course you do. Your leg up on the side of the bathtub.
Leg up on the side. There's a grab the balls. Everything's kind of being shifted to one side. And then we're doing like a full on like dump truck like scoop under. Yeah.
This
I'm pretty sure females, that's how they wipe also. Yeah.
Oh, the dump truck scoop under is not a thing I wanted to hear today.
Oh my goodness. Oh, we took this to a place. We took it to a place.
You asked for it, Ty.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that's all the videos I have for you guys. Josh, any closing words for the people out there?
No, this was good. This was good fun. Love talking to you guys.
Why'd you say no?
I said no. No.
No.
Yeah.
But also.
No. With all due respect.
Dave, any parting words?
Yeah. Wash your fucking hands and wear your goddamn masks, you idiots.
Yeah. Boom. And let me know.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank all of you. Thank everyone for watching. Thank everyone just for being great. Bye.
This is the best thing I've done in 2020.
On the internet.
The bar is not very high.
I was going to say, yeah.